Remember AI phone agents? They are yesterday's news. People ignore unknown calls and nobody wants to be cold-called by AI. So the future of AI calling lives where 3 billion people already are, and that's WhatsApp. So let's start by quick call. So I built this AI voice agent using VideoSDK. So I'm gonna make a quick call. You see, it's ringing. Hey, can you tell me use of AI voice agent in WhatsApp?
A. AI voice agents in WhatsApp can automate customer service, provide information, and handle basic inquiries.
Yeah, that's all I wanted to know. So the agent you just saw in the demo is very easy to build. The entire process can be broken down into three main stages, which we will follow step by step. First, we will handle Twilio and WhatsApp prerequisite. This includes steps like buying a phone number from Twilio, linking it with Meta Business's account as a WhatsApp sender, and most importantly, enabling voice call. Next step is deploying our voice agent to VideoSDK cloud so that once it is deployed, we can easily dispatch that agent whenever someone makes a call from WhatsApp. So what's going to happen is we are going to add inbound gateway to VideoSDK dashboard, and in routing rules we are going to specify this deployed agent. Let me just give you a hint. So the agent which is created here would be added to the routing rule part here, the third part. So basically what happened is from the second step, you would get a deployment ID. So whenever someone makes a call from the WhatsApp, it is automatically going to dispatch our AI agent, and AI agent would be connected to a VideoSDK dynamic room. So let's dive right into the step one and get our Twilio and WhatsApp foundation set up. So let's start with very first step, which is connecting Twilio's number to Meta Business's account. First, you have to create a Twilio account. For that, you can navigate to console.twilio.com. There, if you are signing up for first time, then you have to add your email and maybe you have to verify your number. So once you do that, there will be a dashboard for you that would look something like that. And on the left sidebar, you will see phone number section. Right now it is not there because I've customized it a little bit, but you can always search here. So I'll search for numbers. You see, we have options for buy a number and phone number. So if you click on phone numbers, there you will see all the numbers that you have purchased from Twilio. And if you want to buy, if you have nothing here in this list, you can buy a number. It would cost some $1 to $2 or something. So there you will see a list of number where you can choose from. You just have to click on this buy button. There you can buy this number. And if you want some advanced capabilities like SMS and MMS, then you have to register for that. So you can simply buy a number here. So once you do that, it would be there in active numbers list. So this is the first part. And the next part would be adding WhatsApp senders. For that, you can just search here WhatsApp senders. You can always search here. It's very easy to navigate between different pages. Sometimes you forgot with a lot of pages, right, where you should go. You see, I've already added two WhatsApp sender number and they are already connected with my Meta Business's account. But if you are starting first time, just click on create new sender here, select your Twilio number, click continue, and then you have to connect it with Facebook Business's account or Meta Business's account. So simply click on this button. So there, once you start, you just have to fill up basic details, complete all these steps. Once you do that, OTP would be generated for you, then that you have to specify here. And after saving these changes, your number would be there in the list with status online. Now, if you move to the Facebook Business's account, there you would see your number in active numbers list. You just have to click on this number and make sure you see this message, which is 1000 businesses initiated conversation. So once this part is enabled, that means you can send 1000 messages or something. Now the important part here is this call tab. Make sure this part is enabled, AI voice call, otherwise you won't be able to connect AI voice agent. Now let's move to our second part, which is deploying AI voice agent to VideoSDK cloud. And finally, we are going to connect it with SIP. So let's start by deploying AI voice agent to VideoSDK cloud. But first, let me give you a very simple idea why we are even doing that. So whenever someone makes a call from WhatsApp, that call is forwarded to Twilio. Then Twilio forward that call to VideoSDK SIP gateway. In next step, we are going to perform all these steps in VideoSDK dashboard itself. And then using routing rules, we can connect that SIP user to VideoSDK room. Also, we have to dispatch an AI agent. Now, to dispatch that AI agent, first we need to deploy it to VideoSDK cloud. So that's why we have this code that we are going to deploy. So we're gonna follow a few simple steps. First, we're gonna clone this repository. You see, I've cloned this repository. Also, I navigated to this folder. Next, I'll just open it inside my code editor. Next, I have to create a virtual environment. First, you have to run this command, then you have to activate your virtual environment. If you are using Windows, make sure you use this command. So I'll run all these three commands here. You see all the packages are downloaded from requirements file. I'm using VideoSDK agent, VideoSDK, so that I can use VideoSDK CLI. And also the Google plugin provided by VideoSDK. So if you look at this code itself, here I can define persona for my AI agent. And this start session method actually being executed by the worker, where in the make context, you can see all the room options that we have to provide. All right, everything is installed. But before deploying to VideoSDK cloud, first let's run this AI agent locally so that we can see how it works. And finally, we are going to deploy it using just one script. To deploy this AI agent, you need few tokens. You need VDSTK token. You need a room ID. Also, I'm using here Google API key. So all these keys are mentioned here in this template file. So I'm gonna create a ENV file. There I'll simply copy these values. Now, first let's create our Google API key. For that, you can go to astudio.google.com/app/API keys. There, create a new API key. So I'm gonna delete this key after using in this project so that you don't misuse it. Next, I also need to create VDSTK token. That you can create at app.vdstk.live. There you just have to sign up. So once you sign up, you will get 10,000 free minutes every month. So that's a lot of minutes. Go to API keys, click this key icon, select an expiry for your token, and that's it. That's how easy it is. Finally, we need a room ID. Right now, we are going to create one room ID by making an API request. But because a lot of people would be, you know, making a call from WhatsApp, we have to dynamically create a new room ID. But right now, we can create one room ID by making a simple request to VideoSDK rooms endpoint. If you want to know more about all the API keys we provide, you can go docs.vdstk.live in guide. In REST API, you would see all the API that you can make use of. Here, I'm just using this create room API, and the output would be a simple room ID. So let's create it. So I'm using REST client here. If you don't know what REST client is, it's a extension that you can use to make API requests directly from the VS code. So simply press Control Shift X. In extensions, you can search for REST client, and then you just have to install this extension. So I've already installed it, and I created this file.http. Here I'm making a post request to VDSTK's endpoint. Let's make this request. VDSTK auth token is actually coming from .env file. You see, the request is successful. We have got our room ID as well. That's the room ID. So I'll simply add it here. Now we just have to run our main file. You see, a preview URL is generated for you. You just have to open it inside browser to interact with AI agent. So first let's interact with browser and then we're gonna make use of WhatsApp call. Hi.
Hi, what can I do for you?
See, okay, so our agent is working fine. All we gotta do is deploy this AI agent. Now for deployment, I already mentioned all the steps here in this readme. So for deployment, you first have to create a unique deployment ID. By the way, you can refer to VideoSDK docs for that. So there you can see, you can easily create a deployment ID using our deployment endpoint. So I have already added that request as well. You just need VideoSDK token. And this part is important because this name field would be visible in VideoSDK dashboard. So make sure you give it some name. I can give you one example. So these are the agent section. Here I have all the deployments that I have done so far. All right, so let's make an API call. You see, we have got this ID, which is deployment ID, and we just have to mention it inside our YAML file. Next, we have to add VDSDK token, so we can use same token. And finally, we can run a VDSDK deploy command, but there's one thing that you need to take care of. We have used a static room ID in previous example, but we have to pass a room ID here. So first remove this room ID from the env file because it would be dynamically generated for us because a lot of people would be making calls. So we have to take care of that. Now let's run our final command, which is VDSDK deploy. You see, deployment has started, and after 1 or 2 minutes, it would be live. You see, finally, our agent is deployed to VDSDK. So let's see it in dashboard itself. So I'm gonna refresh this. You see, our agent has been deployed. Our next part would be adding inbound gateway and finally connecting it with the routing rules so that we can spin up an AI agent whenever someone makes a call. Let's start with the last step. We are done with very two step. In second step, we created the deployment ID, deployed AI agent to VDSDK cloud. Next, we're gonna use the deployment ID in our routing rule so that whenever someone's make a call from WhatsApp, we connect that AI agent. Okay, so I've already mentioned these two steps in the readme itself. In part one, we have to add inbound gateway in VDSDK dashboard. For that, you can simply go to the dashboard in telephony section. There you will see inbound gateway. Simply click on this button, add new inbound gateway, and then you can give it any name you would like. So I'll call it WhatsApp agent. Next, you have to add your provider's number. Remember, we previously configured this WhatsApp sender number with Meta, so you can add the same number here. Next, you can give it some tags so that you can easily filter it in dashboard. And that's it. Simply click this create inbound gateway and we are done with part one. In part two, we have to create this Twilio bin app so that whenever someone makes a call from the WhatsApp, this call is routed to our SIP provider. For that, I'll just search here TwiML bin. Once you click on this TwiML bins, there you will see list of all the apps that you have created so far. Click this create icon. There, if you look at the readme, we have to add VideoSDK SIP URI there. So I've already copied it and I'll just paste it here. So this is the template code. There you have to add this SIP URI from the dashboard. So this is your SIP URI. I just added it here. After giving it some name, simply click on this create button. And if you go to the bins, you see our app is added. And the last step is creating routing rules. So again in dashboard, in routing rules, click this add new routing rules, give it some name, let's say WhatsApp agent inbound, select the direction, also the gateway. So this is what we have created in last step. There we can select our number. This number would automatically appear. And next part is important because whenever someone's make a call, let's say there are 1,000 people that are making calls, so we want to connect them in separate rooms. So we have to keep this part dynamic. If you want to connect it to a specific room, you can specify VideoSDK room ID. We already discussed that in last segments. And in agent configuration, because we have deployed it to VideoSDK cloud, we can select our deployment. Remember, we created this deployment. And that's it. Simply click this create routing rule. Now, everything is done from our end. Now, if you make a call from WhatsApp, what's going to happen? It would be routed to Twilio. Then Twilio is going to route it to VideoSDK, where a room would be created and AI agent will be dispatched. So let's make a call. You see, I'm using same Twilio number in WhatsApp to connect to my AI voice agent. Having a voice agent is useful in many ways. Remember AI phone agents, they are yesterday's news. People ignore unknown calls and nobody wants to be cold-called by AI. So the future of AI calling lives where 3 billion people already are, and that's WhatsApp. So let's start by quick call. So I built this AI voice agent using VideoSDK. So I'm gonna make a quick call. You see, it's ringing.
Hello, how can I help you today?
Hey, can you tell me use of AI voice agent in WhatsApp?
A, iVoice agents in WhatsApp can automate customer service, provide information, and handle basic inquiries. Want to know more?
Yeah, that's all I wanted to know. So we have already discussed this GitHub repository. All you gotta do is follow it step by step and you will be able to build your own AI WhatsApp agent. Also, you can follow our documentation to understand more capabilities of AI voice agent. And if you face any problem while implementing it, you can join our Discord community. And in next video, we are going to eliminate Twilio part, where we are going to build AI voice agents without the use of Twilio. Or maybe drop a comment for more videos like this. Maybe we can integrate some Hindi voices. We can integrate Indian numbers as well. So that's all from me. Thanks for watching.